In a statement released Sunday afternoon on his X account, formerly known as Twitter, President Yoweri Museveni defended the decision by government to ditch Kenyan middlemen in favor of Uganda directly purchasing petroleum products from the international market. The president said Uganda imports 2.5 billion liters of fuel per year, worth $2 billion, but noted that behind his back, officials opted to buy it through middlemen in Kenya. He questioned the rationale behind buying through and from middlemen, yet there are refineries. Currently, Ugandan oil marketing companies buy fuel from the international market through Kenyan middlemen. However, Museveni says these have been cheating Uganda. The president informed Ugandans that a check on one occasion a few months ago showed that the middlemen were selling them petroleum products at prices, he went on to indicate, per ton. He said diesel was sold at $118 by the middlemen, and yet the price from the bulk suppliers or refiners was $83 per ton. On petrol, he said the middlemen's price was $97.5, and that of bulk suppliers or refiners was $61.5. On kerosene, he said middlemen's price was $114, and bulk suppliers or refiners were selling at $79. President Yoweri Museveni says these are prices when the products had arrived at the East African ports. In a bid to get a better price, the government will empower Ugandan National Oil Company, which will be helped by a Dutch oil giant, Vitol Brahen, to buy fuel from the international market. Speaking during the press world talk show on Urban TV yesterday, Solomon Muita, the Energy Ministry spokesperson, said the move will result in lower unstable pump prices.
The system that we are trying to get to run away from was structured in a way that it gave our neighbors, Kenya, case in point, an advantage. They receive the products and they mark it up. So by the time a Ugandan company accesses the product, it's already expensive. So what we are trying to take out is that additional cost.
With the middleman.
Yeah, you can look at that Kenyan company as a middleman. So if you take this middleman out of the equation, and you know, you're getting the product directly
to the company,
you're going to offer it to your oil marketing company at the lowest possible price.
But local importers say the partnership between Vitol Bahrain and UNOC looks like a monopoly will be created on the Ugandan market. On Tuesday, Energy Minister Ruth Nankabirwa tabled the Petroleum Supply Amendment Bill 2023 to effect the new development. Nankabirwa had also earlier met Kenya's president to deliver to him his Ugandan counterpart's message on the matter.
With Section 76 of the Public Finance Management Act of 2015 and our rules, Rule 118 of the Rules of Procedure of Parliament, I beg to lay on table the Certificate of Financial Implication to this Petroleum Supply Amendment Bill of 2023.
Speaking during the Urban TV Press World Show on Saturday, Captain Mike Mukula, one of the board members of Mahathi Infra Uganda Limited, a company that ships in fuel via Lake Victoria, said the Vitol Bahrain UNOC partnership will create a monopoly which is dangerous.
Vivo, which you call Shell Vivo. Vivo is the largest fuel OMC company in the country. They have over 152 petrol stations. So end to end, Vitol is going to be a lead player. It is going to have control and monopoly of our stocks and trade, meaning from supply to distribution.
In October 2023, the government decided to enhance its involvement in ensuring the security of the supply of petroleum products into the country by mandating UNOC to source and supply the products to oil marketing companies. This was after UNOC and Vitol Bahrain EC negotiated and signed a bidding 5-year supply partnership contract in August. Uganda is currently a net importer of petroleum products, where more than 90% are imported through the Mombasa port in Kenya and the rest through the Dar es Salaam port in Tanzania. The importation is currently done independently by the licensed oil marketing companies through the importation structures in Kenya and Tanzania. Report compiled by Sam Wakaka for the news.